Joe, we live in a growing, thriving community. Just look at what's occurred on Fayetteville Street in just a few years. We need to have that same accelerated vision for transit. I understand that bus rapid transit is becoming a best practice in some of the fastest growing markets in the United States. Those regions are bringing innovative, scalable transit solutions to the market quickly, but most of us don't have a real knowledge of bus rapid transit.
Tom, you're exactly right. Eugene and Seattle are two progressive, fast-growing metro areas with a high-tech economy that are implementing various elements of bus rapid transit. Those elements would include dedicated lanes and stations in both freeways and streets, priority measures at intersections to keep transit moving, and high-frequency, reliable all-day service.
Joe, that's exciting. Let's head to the Pacific Northwest and see what we can discover firsthand about their innovative approaches to accelerating enhanced transit and share what we learn with the community.
Tom, that's a great idea, and I think this trip will help our growing community make a more informed decision about how we could create an advanced transit network as soon as possible.
Let's get moving.
I feel like it's been incredible. A lot of students use this to come from downtown, between the downtowns. It's a major use for getting to class as well as getting to sporting events.
Do people need to even own cars here? Do you have a car?
I don't have a car, actually.
But in the Puget Sound region, we have more than 500,000 people getting on and off a bus every day. It's going to be the majority of transit riders on buses for the next decade, if not longer.
Traffic's getting worse. It's harder for people to move around. And in order to actually begin to address that in a big way, in a quick way, you know, we need to do what we can with some of the paint on the ground. Bus rapid transit can be put in place a lot quicker.
Bus rapid transit really fit. It was something we felt wasn't going to cost millions and millions of dollars.
They're always on time. I don't think I've ever seen a bus run more than like 30 seconds late of what it's supposed to be.
One of the overarching goals of SWIFT was what we call 10-second dwells. So when a bus stops at the station, it's only there for 10 seconds. We run at 12-minute frequencies from 5 a.m. till 7 p.m. and 20 minutes in the evening. So we don't necessarily have peak off-peak service. We're running a consistent frequency all day long.
The RapidRide in Seattle has been wildly successful in terms of the ridership gains from the previous bus lines that it replaced, finding those choke points, finding the places where congestion's the worst, and getting the buses to the front of the line, whether it's a queue jump or signal priority.
What the TSP does, it's a low-level priority that gives buses either a longer green or a shorter red.
And it's got this beautiful quality. It opens and closes at street level, just like your light rail does. Works with a traffic light, so you move rapidly. It comes every 10 minutes.
Rather than having a milk run where you're very slowly moving from one location to another with multiple stops, bus rapid transit along the freeway allows you to just move quickly.
Oh, I love it, because now I finally meet people. And I have actually discovered Springfield.
But it's got to be a higher level of, a higher quality of experience for the rider than just your average bus stop.
So when you have an actual station that's designed well, that is visible, that has an identity, that's integrated with art, has good information about when next buses are coming, they become a place and a gathering spot and can become a focus for development, for transit-oriented development. And I've seen that happen here in Eugene.
Previously, when we built the corridor, we really divided communities north-south. Mm-hmm. And so portions of this lid are dedicated to really connecting the neighborhoods mm-hmm. back up together. A portion of the lid is dedicated to transit access.
So the redevelopment of this corridor next to the university had been auto-dominant, low density forever. Nothing changed until the bus rapid transit went in. So it's pretty straightforward that the investment and the building of the bus rapid transit was a direct catalyst for the land use change and the redevelopment of the area.
I can tell you from firsthand experience, the developers I talked to are very excited about the immediacy and the availability of the bus rapid transit system, because they're not thinking in terms of what their development will be like in 15 years. They're having to make their pro forma work in the next 3 years.
Bus rapid transit can certainly have economic development benefits, very similar to light rail if it's done correctly. And it's, to a certain extent, it's about the level of permanence.
We're the ones that are doing the permanent infrastructure development by providing the pedestrian amenities. The BRT will never go anywhere else after what we've done.
I can't imagine this facility working as well as it does without bus rapid transit.
what you end up with is a development opportunity that doesn't look like circles, it looks like a corridor. And that is exactly what we had in Shoreline.
I think going big is one of the key ingredients. Don't just do one line and put all your eggs in that one basket. Make sure that you've got more of a network approach.
So one of the things that makes bus rapid transit so attractive is that it's taking a limited amount of money and maximizing the number of links of the system that gets created.
This is the system for today. This is the system for tomorrow. This is the system for the far-reaching future that we envision for this community.
The main thing I would change about our bus rapid transit system here in the region is I would have the Chamber of Commerce, transit agencies, local municipalities, and other business owners that put forth a vision of why a system of rapid transportation is not only good for its users, it's good for economic development, it's good for public resources being used efficiently. It's just a good community asset, and I think there would be great value in telling that story.
Joe, I was really impressed with the innovations we saw in the bus systems in both Eugene and Seattle. I think several of these could align with the goals and values of our community.
Tom, I agree. The innovations that we saw could create a lot of benefits for us, focusing economic development included. But one of the main benefits would be freedom for all the members of our community. Freedom from congestion, freedom from transit schedules, and freedom from having to worry about driving or parking.
Joe, you know what? I think it's time to start sharing what we've learned with the community about innovative bus rapid transit as an option for our region. What do you think?
Tom, I think you just did.